Hello, gamers. Are you ready? Are you ready to come back with us to the first Gamergate? I hope so. Serb, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm just looking at Gamergate images.
Okay. Serb and I are here to take you back to the past to play the one game that came out of Gamergate that is actually about Gamergate somehow. It's been 10 years. Can you believe it, Serb?
That's wild. I have... Okay, I'm going to reply this to you so you can bump your tweet. This is one of my favorite images.
Oh, God. Serb, what are you saying to me?
The day we went to war.
Who's on? Who did we have on our team? The pro gamer side.
We have the internet aristocrat, CM Punk for some reason.
What?
JonTron... Ken Ashcorp, that's an old one.
Talk Funny Chunk. Funny Chunk.
You have Boogie.
Okay, oh, everyone loves Boogie. He's like the Mr. Rogers of the internet.
Know Your Meme.
Oh.
Freddy Fazbear.
Oh.
Something called Game Nosh.
Game Nosh?
I don't know.
Yo, we got Game Nosh. That's like having like Walter Cronkite in your corner, you know? That's how you know you've won.
We have Adachi from Persona 4. I've seen there's one with more.
He would be a gamer gator. Yeah, that makes sense.
Gamergate pro Gamergate memes were so fucking fruity.
They were amazing. They were just like, it's hard to even like explain it if you were not there. If you weren't there, this is going to be a very confusing stream because you're going to wonder what the fuck happened.
I found one of even more guys on it that is just weird.
Oh, really?
All right, this one, I'm going to... Can I send this to you so you...
You absolutely, absolutely, yes, you can.
All right, so this is important.
How's the audio, by the way, guys? Can you hear us? Can you hear the... I guess you can hear a bit of the game. All right, I am looking at this right now. What in God's name? All right, hang on. What the fuck? All right. Wow, okay. Who have we got here? We got some real...
We got RockCock64.
We got some characters here. All right, damn. Okay.
We have WWE wrestler Dean Ambrose for some reason.
What... We have Ed's World. I think I see Ed's World.
That's not Ed's World.
Who is that?
I don't know.
Did he die supporting Gamergate?
No. He died a brony.
Oh, no.
You got Sargon of Akkad. The Young Capitalists. That was the game that they were supposedly going to like get Vivian James to be a
character. Oh, man. They had the nod respectfully guy who I miss and I love. What's his story?
I don't know. He just said nods respectfully in your direction.
He made one post and I'm still thinking about it 10 years later.
You have Camille Nanjiani who, as we all know, destroyed his body for the Eternals.
God bless him.
Phil Fish, Rock Paper Shotgun, Jezebel.
Oh boy.
The Die Sis Scum Lady.
Uh-huh.
Notch.
Notch. Notch was pro... Wait, what? Notch was anti-Gamergate?
He was anti.
Notch is an SJW, damn. He turned to the dark... Man, how'd they get him?
I'm just seeing... we have the red SJW.
Okay, that lady... I hope that girl gets, like, royalties from how often her image gets used. She just had like one bad day, and then that's like the only thing anyone will remember her for.
Let's see. You have Shoe-On Head.
Who is she? Is she in like? Is she a Nazi now again? What's her deal? Who's she dating?
I'd have to check.
All right.
We got the Franker Z Dog, which is a Twitch emote.
Oh boy.
Some guy that looks like Markiplier. But isn't?
It's not Markiplier. You've got... Boy, there are some characters here.
We have bodybuilding.com.
Thank God.
Protein pill. Andrew Dobson.
Andrew Dobson. Okay.
That's a
Wizard Chan is on our side. Okay, thank God. Tech Raptor.
Anthony Fantano. No. If you look right beneath the 08, you can see Fantano.
I can see Fantano. Oh my God. One fader article, and it destroyed his life.
It didn't destroy his life. It just turned him into musical iDubbbz.
We had U-Porn.
I see a Sonin Rad for some reason.
Oh, gee whiz.
But I also see the Happy Merchant on the back.
I see him. What's he doing over there?
I don't know.
He's just chilling. All right. Shall we get this show on the road?
Yeah, I could look at this all day.
I'm sure we could find more beautiful gamer art. Oh, hang on. A video is coming our way, sir. What is it?
All right. Oh, when it comes to videos, oh man.
When it comes to videos, please, we want to remember everything. Let me just turn the music off real quick. Okay,
Yeah, that's loud.
Oh, this one's a classic.
This is a very dark human tail mask. It's very troubled and dark heart. And the fallacy of anthropocentrism that placed mankind's existence
in the center of natural order.
Like the foliage
asserting itself over brick and steel, the mindless drive to exist becomes its own form of zombification, replete with desperation, denial, and terrifying justification. Fighting the feeble authority of the establishment and offering the uncertain hope of a better future in dire times.
Who?
The narrative advantage of games is fully realized in a manner with no equal in the media. These characters are so accustomed to loss that you see their faces fighting back actual feelings.
Wow.
And breaks in their facade come from moments as gentle as looking at a watch. Playing the uncomfortably ambivalent character
Adam
of Joel.
Adam Susser is like a guy that you can remind him, like on Twitter, that he like put on Ellie, yellow face to make fun of Japanese games.
Don Quixote at the end of the
and
world.
He's like, they deserved it.
Gameplay perfectly integrates in design and tone that sets the game apart and overcomes the frequent issues with dissonance in major releases.
Oh my
Joel
God.
Has no preternatural skill.
Oh my God, this was
chat,
at PAX West.
Is
oh my God, I have something.
Oh please. This moment
when Ellie happens upon an old arcade cabinet. Joel,
2013 was dark. This was a dark time in games.
By the veneer of survival, define his violent nature and snatch the player up in the moment, willing or not. The dire, noxious tension that at times
God, the double
dark
wombo
souls
combo
is
of
only
this and
relieved
BioShock
by dispatching
Infinite?
These living
Jesus.
Obstacles to the goal of making it through one more moment. There's something momentarily relieving and viscerally satisfying that then gives way to the nauseating implications of the act. Naughty Dog's awareness of the violence and its unflinching intrusion on the player's psyche is a necessary recalibration of the role of violence in games and will undoubtedly be part of the ongoing debate in the media.
Okay, here. Yeah, all right.
All right, please.
This one's a favorite, and this will be the last one for now, but please, if you guys got money, want to see a video, you got videos?
You got videos?
Scroll right on down.
Send that shit through, gamers.
This is a favorite.
Oh, what have you got?
It's magic trick adjacent.
Oh, great. I love magic tricks. Let's see what we got. Oh my God. I've forgotten.
Hawaiian. Nobody tastes eggs and bacon when they're frying. That just be dumb. You probably burn your tongue and nobody
has anybody
a
seen my USB
unless he's crying. Nobody much likes it when the neighbors are always prying.
Oh my God.
Nobody really likes Meg Ryan movies that much, do they? Except Meg Ryan. And
wow.
Even she's not really sure these days. Nobody likes the CIA always spying and running right-wing paramilitary death squads. Nobody likes a bigot unless he's crying. Boo-hoo,
what?
Like a boo-hoo. Boo-hoo. Most people hate bigots because they're assholes, right? Judgmental agents of fear. You know who probably hates bigots even more? Who, Randy? Themselves.
Get their asses, Randy.
Crying like a gamer gator. With self-loathing and low self-esteem. Let's take the esteem down even lower now. Nobody much likes it when those Buddhists are always pacifying. One day they're just gonna fucking hit someone. Nobody likes a confused giant.
Can you imagine if this was your boss? Like, you work 16-hour days for this man?
Yeah.
Nobody watches the clothes when they're drying. Unless you're stoned in a laundromat. And nobody likes a bigot.
I need to explain something about Game Brigade.
Boo-hoo.
Because, it is what
nobody likes.
You need to understand
when he's crying.
You need to
sing
understand.
Nobody likes a bigot.
These people were so fucking obnoxious that fascism came back. That is how annoying they were.
This one was donated.
Oh boy.
Well, here we are again.
What the hell
it's
is this?
Such a
I don't know.
Remember when you tried to call us dead? Oh, how we laughed and laughed. Except we weren't laughing.
Oh.
But in the circumstances, we've been making more friends. You want your $10? Take them. That's what we're counting on. Used to want you broke, but now we only want you gone.
Oh man.
They were a lot like you.
I had forgotten
but
this.
Quite a bit the shit lord. Now Base Mom and Milo
are
in here
too.
One day they picked us up. So we could video forever. It's such a shame the same will never happen to you. You got your oversized egos. That's what we're counting on. We'll let you get to unemployment.
How long is this?
We only want
I don't know.
Gone.
Jesus Christ.
Goodbye, our
we're
only friend. Oh, did you think we meant you? That would be funny.
Oh, brace yourselves, gamers.
So sad. Well, you have been
I
replaced.
Whoever made this is dead.
We don't need shitty sights now. When we defeat you, maybe we'll start feeling so glad. Go make a PR disaster. That's what we're counting on. You're someone else's megaphone.
Jesus
now we
Christ.
Only want you gone. Now we only want you gone.
Can you imagine Israelis singing this parody song like this about Palestinians?
I can, that's not a joke.
Yeah, I know.
I can absolutely imagine that being a thing. Oh my god. Whoa.
Who lives on stolen land?
You do.
You do.
Okay.
Voodoo? Me, Jew.
Oh, alright. Are you ready? We're actually playing the game all right. now.
Alright.
Oh. Oh, thank God. Make sure you follow and sub, everyone. Oh,
are
my...
you my shield?
Yes.
The apocalypse. The apocalypse never changes.
Oh, boy.
Except in this case, when it's brought upon by a man and his dog. We rejoin our two heroes, the postal dude and his beloved sidekick Champ, as they narrowly escape the nuclear destruction of their apocalyptic weekend escapades. Having braved everything the world could throw at them this past week, all seems well for the two.
Yep, looks like everything worked out pretty good in the end. Eh, Champ?
Unfortunately for them, their triumph would be short-lived.
Oh no.
What the
oh no.
Stupid dog.
The dude hastily turns about in pursuit of his loyal companion, speeding down the way from whence he came. The ever-expanding mushroom cloud looming over the horizon only grows larger as he nears. However, it's not the imminent radioactive fallout that proves to be the greatest danger.
Ugh, this damn head wound. Crap. Not now.
Damage.
Oh, no.
Trapped in the inky blackness of his mind, the dude suffers terrifying, frightful images of a future gone wrong.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I regret nothing.
He awakens with a shock. It was all just a horrible nightmare. Or was it? A concerned Good Samaritan stands idly by.
Are you all right?
It's this damn bullet lodged in
I like how the I like how the drawn character has the same exact stance as a postal pedestrian.
Yes, he does. I think I'm just fine now. I think they just drew over this.
What the hell was that?
Mysterious voice changing aside, the postal dude learns he has miraculously recovered from an 11-year radiation-induced coma. He now stands at the outskirts of an unfamiliar town.
Yeah, it's just a filter.
If he wishes to find his lost dog, Champ, he'll have to begin his search there. The Good Samaritan offers one final piece of assistance.
Take this map fragment to guide you as you begin your journey. It looks like you have an interesting day ahead of you.
Yeah, it's Tom goes to the mayor.
Good luck.
Armed with nothing but a tattered map piece and a box of matches, our intrepid hero takes the first tentative steps into the unknown town. Yet strangely, one that seems somewhat familiar.
Okay, so here we go. DLC to a 12-year-old at the time game.
I found it really cool that they even made a sequel. Like,
I
thought it was neat that they did.
I do too. No, I thought this was really like a cool thing to do. It's like an old game, but you have like a... This is made by the guys that made Eternal Damnation, by the way.
Yeah.
They pretty much... They like knew the engine like no one else at this point. And this is after Postal 3, which was a colossal piece of shit.
I have to ask around to see if anyone's seen Champ recently.
I'm sure the fourth one is also not very good.
No, we'll get to that. Ask anybody.
Maybe Champ ended up at a local animal control center. Wouldn't be the first time. Let's see. Guess I need to go here for that. And while I'm at it, I might as well get a bite to eat. You really work up an appetite after 11 years. Ah, there's a cock Asian in town. I hope they didn't make a hot dog out of Champ.
So, I think we just need to give Postal 4 more time, because I remember when Postal 2 came out, there's three different iterations of Postal 2. There's the base game, which was broken as fuck when it came out. If you played Postal 2 when it came out, you might remember that the load times between zones were about 2 minutes each.
Wow.
Yes. Even on the best computer at the time, it would still take about 2 minutes to load. That's how fucking wonky it was. But, Share the Pain came out, that fixed a lot of stuff. Apocalypse Weekend fixed a lot of stuff, and this is the second one, the third one actually, Paradise Lost, which also
I saw that they added even more new things, like a crack cola. I haven't played that game in a while and they still have new shit.
Yeah, basically you're not even playing the same game anymore, more or less. It's kind of weird in that sense.
I don't think you're getting across.
Oh, I am, don't worry. But yeah, it's kind of bizarre in that sense that you're like playing a game that has just been like when it came out, it was unplayable. Like if you're old enough to remember, you might remember the A Week in Paradise mod for this game, which was the most unstable fucking thing on the planet. But it was really cool.
What was A Week in Paradise?
Where it makes the base game and Apocalypse Weekend. It combines the two.
Excuse me, have you seen this lost dog?
Shit!
Ah! Strange.
Good for them.
Maybe someone else can clue me in.
We're in a Game of Thrones t-shirt.
Jesus. Yeah, there's some very, very dated humor in this.
Hi there. Have you seen this adorable pooch recently? That was odd. Guess I need to keep asking around.
Why are people scared of my dog? This is you showing women your dog, sir.
Pardon me. Can you identify the lost canine in this photo?
Sweet Lord, no!
Ah! Jeez, again? I wonder. Hey, you with the face. Have you seen this dog before? Fuck. I think
Serb's like, have you seen my dog Malcolm? And this is how women react to him. They just run away.
You there.
They hate
what
him.
What do you think about the dog in this photo?
Coming through.
Hello, sir or madam. Can you tell me if you've seen this dog?
You already asked him.
I already asked him. Damn. All right.
You there. What do you think about the dog in this photo?
Sweet Lord, no!
Everyone's screaming about my dog. Jesus.
Hey, before you freak out in terror, can you tell me anything you know about this?
Jesucristo, ayúdame!
Oh. Another reaction of pure terror. Better keep checking around.
Damn. Everyone's freaking out about my dog.
Hey, fuckhead. Are you just gonna run around?
I'm calling the cops!
No, you're not. What do you mean cops? The apocalypse happened. Oh yeah, so this is kind of just all the base materials from the original Postal 2, but they've kind of just remixed it for a post-apocalyptic theme. This came out like I think around the same time Fallout 4 did.
Oh yeah, so were they rolling really heavy with that?
They were rolling hard with that.
I'm gonna reduce you to a state of pure terror.
It's horrible.
What a surprise! You better tell me right now what you know about this dog, or I'll follow you home and kill you. What a surprise!
What a surprise! Right.
Just doesn't
Will
care.
Will you spill your guts about this dog, or should I do it for you?
Sweet Lord, no!
What's wrong with that guy?
Probably help if I ask someone else.
Everyone's freaking the fuck out about my dog.
You better tell me. I wonder what the mall looks like. About this dog, or I'll follow you home and kill your dog.
He doesn't care.
You should go speak to the wise man. He knows all around these parts.
All right, we gotta go speak to the wise man.
Well, wasn't that enlightening?
Yeah, the mall is really fucking annoying in this mod. Not the mod, this is an official expansion.
Now, where is that? That looks like the place.
Finally. Jesus. How you been, Serb, since you ran away from home after your dad asked you to take out the garbage?
I'm good. It's all been taken care of. Wait, is the mall Chinese now?
No, the mall... Creature Control Center Pet... Yes, they made the mall Chinese.
Awesome.
We should talk more about Postal 4 and how it's like... It came out in like a pre-alpha state.
Yeah, that was one of the first games we ever streamed.
Postal 4?
Yeah.
No kidding. That can't be right.
Well, not one of the first, but it was at the very least like.
I don't remember. I remember we streamed it once, but I don't remember it being.
It was the first time we ever broke 40 viewers.
Well, that's
viewers.
Not right. Nope, not him.
Damn.
You gotta be fucking kidding.
Look at that dog. Massive gaslighting effort by Postal fans to convince people 4 was good. That was bizarre, and that people were like, yeah, you know, this game sucks complete ass and is miserable to play, but hey. The dev is cool on Twitter, and now that, like, the weird thing about the Twitter account for Running With Scissors, have you seen it? Have you been blocked by them?
No.
Nope, looks like
Champions. Oh, they just talk shit about other games.
Yeah, I follow the main, actually, I do something worse. I follow Vince from, Postal.
Oh, he's cool.
And he is a big Q guy.
Yeah, okay, so, one of the things with Postal 2 is that it's made by Republicans. It's very interesting to see how that, like, yeah, it's made by, like, Republicans in Texas.
Aw, does our little pachyderm pal want to show his appreciation?
Oh, hell yes. Oh, no, they're from Arizona, aren't they?
You've got to be fucking kidding.
Paradise is supposed to be in Arizona, yeah.
Yeah, did you see what the Postal do? Okay, yeah, so there's been a bit of a transition in terms of fan bases of this game. If you bought this game when it came out, like, 20 years ago, like, the first thing I remember was going on the Running With Scissors website, and the forums were full of people, like, fucking, like, guys from Finland who just were, like, talking about, oh, you know, my favorite shooting is Columbine. Virginia Tech, also very good. But like,
the gene pool is stagnant, and I am
now, the fan base for this game is like non-binary 14-year-olds, and I don't know how that happened.
You could say the same thing about South Park.
That's bizarre, right?
Yeah, well, because like the girls just want to like draw the boys kissing.
These little simians are looking restless. Maybe I ought to let them out
what
in
the
fresh
fuck?
Air.
Yeah, they got weird funky monkeys in this. Yeah, so the art that you see if you look up Postal 2 now is going to be all of him being like, ow, my top surgery scars. Like, instead of killing people. They made him, like, into a Tumblr sexy man. It's bizarre.
This DIY HRT can't be good for me, but I feel great.
This bathtub estrogen can't be good for me, but I feel great. We're freeing those apes. Oh god. Oh, that's right, the spinny cats. Yeah, every 10 minutes you have to inject estrogen into yourself.
That should be a new, yeah, let's get that as a new consumable.
Yeah. You took the DIY estrogen. Oh no, my monkeys are dead.
My apes, gone!
My apes! They took all of my apes. Oh, don't worry, we got new apes.
You go, girl.
Don't be afraid.
Be not afraid.
Fear not.
And I am the minister of chlorine.
Parents. Yeah, like, they should have that, the, Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, fuck. They found my DIY HRT box. Now they're all gonna pay.
We're gonna get you free from Otokonoko Pharmaceuticals.
Jesus Christ. No, it's, You see that with South Park too, and I have to wonder, are they secondaries? Do they actually watch the show?
I mean, a lot of the girls that draw the boys.
Oh, they actually watch it? Yeah, that's fucking weird. Maybe it's one of those things where, like, I don't know. They have to be like, look, because there was a tweet that the Running with Scissors Twitter did recently where they were like, look, yeah, the postal dude is not transphobic. And I'm like, well, he's a guy who kills everybody and, like, like, the fact that you have to clarify that is so funny.
I like how the people were saying in response, like, oh, well, does he also hate George Floyd? It's like, what? It's like, you are very hyper-fixated on that.
That's very funny, because it's like, you have that Twitter account, and then you can go on, like, the Steam forums, and it's like, can I mod Hillary Clinton into the game? Can there be a level where we go to the DNC?
Just kidding.
And kill Hillary Clinton?
They'd probably do that.
They would do that, because they did that for Tim Shitface. I remember, this is new to me.
Oh, yeah? Well, do tell.
Anyway, I remember everyone during Gamergate was, pushing that his name was an anagram for Mr. Shitface.
Oh, man.
So I always think about that. That's like some poop partyist type shit.
What a dumb time to be on the computer. What an unbelievably stupid time online.
You gotta eat.
I do gotta eat.
Food court?
Yep. Oh, my God. I think about that and just like, so just people rendering themselves unemployable, like, for the rest of their lives just because they were dumb on the computer.
Yeah, really. People are still doing that.
People are still doing that to this day.
It's honestly interesting. They do it for dumber reasons, too.
RockCock64's only lasting contribution to I really liked The Best Gamers, but he made that when he was, like, 18, and he's, like, very ashamed of it, rather understandably.
Oh, yeah.
He like got a girlfriend. He's like, yeah, I don't want to do that no more.
Fuck you, buddy.
Oh yeah, I remember everyone got mad at him for the GDQ tweet that he made.
Oh yeah, about the people in attendance.
Yeah.
Dear me. No, it's one of those guys that's like, I'm quitting Twitter because of Elon Musk, and it's like, yeah, all right, fair enough. It's not as good as it used to be.
It's definitely not good.
Extreme loathing. Is that a hatred? Do they not like hatred?
I don't know.
Crack man. Farm.
Wait. That's meme impact font.
Wait, what? Oh, it is. Jesus. Well, I want to go into the arcade. I can't go in the arcade. What the fuck? Where's the wise man? All right. How do we get out of here? I know what to
You're
do.
You're close to the food court.
Yeah, the mall in this fucking sucks ass to navigate. Hatred is just Postal 1, but Hatred's a fucking stupid game. It's, did you play it, Serb? I had to pirate it because it was banned in Australia.
I'm telling.
Don't tell the government.
Hatred had no cultural lasting impact at all.
That is also a game that came out during Gamergate. Jesus, I forgot about that.
Everyone was pushing it hard because of the Gamergate stuff, and then it turned out not to actually be good. Did they ever make the Vivian James game that they supposedly were going to make? That was really fruity, where like they were like, yeah, we're supporting a women dev group.
Oh, man. See, the thing about...
like, you can't call us sexist.
The thing about Gamergate 2 is that there is no pretense of being, like, about games journalism this time. There is no pretense of, you know, we're a diverse group. It's just, we are right wing and we're going to kill you.
I love it. I love it so much.
I love it. It's way more honest.
Straight to the point.
Straight to the fucking point. Great. Awesome.
We don't have to do all that pageantry.
Yeah, you don't have to be like, you know, here's this woman dev team, women-led dev team, and they're making a game, and I think we should donate to the Kickstarter. I think we should write emails to, you know, let them know our concerns. It's like, no, we're just going to kill you. We're just kill you.
Yeah, no, they skip the part where they pretend to like minorities as long as they hated the same people.
That's what, yes, Jesus.
Hashtag not your shield and all that stuff. And then they're like, nah, we're going straight to the point. Beat the
game just being like, having guys on Twitter like go, you know, actively saying like, look, I don't think we should have black people in games. And then like the blue check game journalist being like, we see past your dog whistles. And it's like, he's not dog whistling. He's being very open about what he wants.
They don't do the dog whistle stuff anymore.
We see through your dog whistles. It's like, yeah, they're not even bothering to hide what they want now.
Yeah, no, it's sorry, man. So the thing is with Sweet Baby is that it's just like, they finally invented annoying fake email jobs for queers, which is awesome.
That's Sweet Baby is a company that you hire to write annoying emails to you, from what I understand.
Yeah. I think, like, the one that the game in particular that they're really mad about is, like, Spider-Man 2.
Oh, no. I love it when those games come out, because I get to see, like, console gamers just be like, yo, I can't look into this window. What the fuck, PS5?
Yeah, that's great.
Well, what was wrong with Spider-Man 2? Did they make it woke?
They made it woke, and they made Mary Jane not fuckable, I guess.
Oh, no.
Chat, what was the main issue people had with Spider-Man 2? Besides it just being mid?
Make sure you follow, by the way. Make sure you sub, by the way. Yeah, what was the issue? Damn. It's weird that they tried to do one for, like, Alan Wake 2, except that game was really good. And the only thing you could have about it was that, like, the main character is like a black woman, one of the main characters, and they're just like, yeah, no, I don't think we should have black people in games. Like, what debate is there to even have with a person like that?
They said that in a side quest they said the word BIPOC.
The what?
BIPOC. BIPOC.
Oh, right. Oh, and that, Jesus.
That was enough.
That was it. Oh boy, that's the end of you. No one says that in real life. That's not a thing you say out loud, right?
Yeah, that I don't know.
That's like saying, like, LGBTQ+, like, in real life. I don't think I've ever heard anyone say it.
Yeah, so in a way, like, there's, like, yeah, they probably shouldn't have that be a fucking, dialogue option.
Didn't you just
annoying
save?
And doesn't happen in real life. So I guess I get it. Yeah, no, it's like a fucking annoying, email company that makes sure that you, say use lines of dialogue in your game that no one fucking says.
Yeah, you need to have like a scene where, like, I think about that Mass Effect 3 where you have like a guy coming up to you being like, my husband just died, will you have sex with me, male shepherd? And you can be like, yes. And I just remember thinking, that's a guy checking a box. They're like, all right, we did it, we put gay people in our game. And then you've also got, like, psychotic stuff like The Last of Us 2, where you, like, butcher an orphanage and then you go to the gay pride rally with your girlfriend.
Oh, yeah. You have a wanted level. You should probably just lay low or something.
Nah, I don't feel like it. I'm going crazy with it.
I love how, like, the entire game is just Neil Gelbit. Neil Druckmann.
Duckman.
Duckman.
Yeah, his name
just,
is Duckman.
Ugh, a long line. Figures. Maybe this highly touted mystery meat will be worth the wait, though.
It better. Alright, time to sit in line. What were you saying, sir?
I forgot what I was gonna say. Oh, yeah, no, the game was, it's a point you usually make, but that game is for Druckman to, just have a power fantasy of killing Palestinians.
The Last of Us 2 is the last gasp of liberal Zionism. That's the last time you could do that before October 7th. It's like, you know, hey, we do just need to kill them all, but Israel supports pride parades.
Something I've been noticing is that, like, you remember that period? I mean, after October 7th, like, you started seeing, like, quote unquote, based people.
Oh, no.
Support Israel instead of, only because out of contrarianism, because it's still Palestine.
Oh, man. Speaking of contrarianism, I saw people defending Dan Schneider after that fucking documentary came out. It's like,
why?
Because normies know about it now.
Yeah, that's pretty much the entire motivation that some people have.
That's just it. It's like you've spent the last 10 years making fun of him to the point where you probably have a laundry list of names that you call him. And you're like, oh, actually, I like him now.
It's so fucking funny when it's like, you have people like saying, oh, Google dancing Israelis or whatever, whatever. And then suddenly normies know about Israel-Palestine. It's like, I don't want to play with this anymore.
Yeah,
actually, this entire
this.
Time, Israel was kind of swaggy with it.
Jesus Christ.
I'm starting to see people see it swing back, like as if there was like a patch notes being released. So like
that's
they patched
what
out.
It feels like, yeah. Like they updated the scripting.
They updated the scripting, and now they're back to hating Israel because Alex Jones hates Israel.
Yeah, I saw Alex Jones come out, and it's just like, I don't know. We'll see where the pendulum swings on that stuff. I like that you can just sit in line in this game. Something
you can technically not kill anybody in your playthrough.
Something I like to say to annoy people is that Postal 2 was the first walking simulator.
Yeah, it can be.
I'm not even technically wrong. You can play this game as a walking simulator where you just don't kill people. It's very funny to me that A. White Man was the pseudonym of a Satanist adjacent Hollywood guy. Yeah, he was friends with everyone because that's just what parties in L.A. were like in the 90s. Sorry. I'm sorry.
Please, help yourself to our vast array of condiments. When's Death Stranding? I don't know. We might as well be watching a movie on that.
Death Stranding's a good game if we were talking over it.
Will we be able to talk over it?
Oh, of course. Like half the game is just doing Uber Eats.
Okay.
Hi there.
That'll work. Thanks.
If you say so.
All right. We did it. We got food.
And done.
We're so good at this game. Oh, what's going to happen?
Ah! Oh my God! Those wild dogs are attacking the restaurant!
Why does this not surprise me?
Help me! Help me! Oh, there's wild dogs. Oh, great. I stood in line for nothing. That's what I get for standing in line. No, Death Stranding is good. It's a game that's like... I like that his vision... was just making...
You could probably get a bunch of free food going to the kitchen.
That's true. But I like that Kojima's vision was just, what if I made quap? What if I had an $80 million budget and I made quap? Oh boy, here I go. Get out, you first... I am trying to get out.
Do you remember that time?
Yeah.
I got turned down the game on my end because it's always interrupted my the me thing. Don't worry about it. Okay. So.
Yeah.
So something I've been like, remember when I organically discovered the synthetic man on stream and I showed it to you like a
My God, one of our favorite YouTube channels.
It was 2 years before you like he started popping up big.
Oh man, yes, I remember.
And it was just like It was just basically like me and you calling him a homo for being really mad at Postal 4 for not being racist enough.
That was the critique of that game. Like, that guy's really cool if you want to see, like, if someone made their whole personality like trying to get V to like them. And if you scroll down his channel, Synthetic Man has called. Me and Serb make fun of him a lot. But, basically, you can paint a portrait of someone who just has, like, depression and doesn't enjoy games anymore.
Oh, I usually... He paints a pretty good picture of a guy who doesn't like games. He just wants to have the perfect V3x3.
That's a guy who, like, you can tell... Like, there's a trap that you can fall into where you can't say anything positive because you won't get views. Because I remember Kroby Cat having to delete, like, a video because he was actually being positive about something. And his fan base were like, what, huh?
Yeah, and he didn't make a video where he just checks whether or not you can shoot at the melons.
Oh, man. That's awesome.
Krobe Cat. Apparently he was discovered to be some other YouTuber.
I don't mind. I don't hate Krobe Cat as much as most people do. I think it's a lot of, like, reset.
A revision. Yeah.
Like, I mean, it's AAA games. You can get mad at him. I'm not gonna lose any sleep over that. But like,
I feel like people overcorrected quite a bit in like going from really liking him to really hating him in recent years.
Yeah, I think so too. But no, adulthood is realizing that Donkey is stupid. That's the only one you actually have to realize.
Oh yeah, he's just fucking like the way he bashes like JRPGs and
that's
shit.
The stuff.
It's not even that. That's like.
That's the criticism I mostly see.
Like adulthood, really. You're an adult when you're like, oh, this guy's a big fat dumbass.
Didn't you just save?
that's when you know you're all good.
I can honestly say I've never watched his videos.
Really?
Never been a Donkey guy. Just doesn't.
Well, yeah, I used to watch him a bit, but it becomes like apparent that I don't know. It's kind of like I don't know, I just think about channels that kind of go into decline a bit, like, you watch Red Letter Media, right?
Yeah, you're talking about this.
Have you noticed that they don't go to the movies anymore?
No.
You haven't?
I don't watch, well, I mean, like, I shouldn't have said I watch Red Letter Media. I know of them. That was another nice thing that passed me by. I never really watched Red Letter Media.
I think they basically, I don't know. I think either the current state of movies just depresses them and they're not being cynical like they used to, or...
can anyone hear?
Like... I don't know, they're just burned out. Oh my god.
That was a channel that, like, I felt like everyone inherited their opinions from them and didn't really have their own for quite a bit.
That's true.
Bitch, you're not just talking to a wise man, you're talking to the wise Wang. You have entered the domain of Kraji, the wise Wang, the source of infinite wisdom and shit. What knowledge is it that you seek, oh shaded one?
Yeah, I'm looking for the dog in this photo.
Where's my dog?
I see you're searching for the legendary El Perro Loco. Few are brave enough to embark on such a journey, and even fewer have returned to tell the tale. And what a grand tale it is. Luckily for you, I've got this educational film strip prepared just for the occasion. Roll that beautiful post-apocalyptic footage, Larry!
You've got it, K-Man. So what, just because I'm the sidekick, I gotta do the crap jobs? Friggin' sprockets. Yeah, I'll give you my 35 millimeters, all right. Hey, is it in focus?
I love you, Dr. Girlfriend.
Our tale begins 11 years ago, when our town was nearly destroyed by...
Oh, man, we just gotta say, we're doing a Valve cutscene, Jesus. Oh, God.
Fallout from this explosion.
Oh, Christ, help, there's lore.
Creating distinct weather zones as one travels closer to the site of the blast. It was at this time
they were really proud of this.
Lost in the they wild, should be.
The town's border, you should whip out your penis and piss on the projector.
As he ventured deeper into the town, the high levels of radiation mutated them into a beast of unspeakable horror. Before too long,
you never played this expansion before? Oh, when it came out. Almost 10 years ago.
Surviving population for years until he moved to the heart of the town.
The very ground. Holy shit, do we have 195?
Probably.
He was permanently sealed off in the aptly named Hellhole, where he resides to this.
Oh, we have some video share stuff. We'll do this while this goes on.
We do?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, yeah. Fuck you. However, fuck you, Crotchy.
Turn it off.
So apt.
Turn it off.
Your only hope of survival is to gain the assistance of the men.
Well done, good timing. Can I just kill Crotchy? Oh, never mind.
But before you go, heed this word of warning. A dark side I sense in you. Beware, for this sinister force lies inside your very mind, growing more and more powerful by the day.
And with those MLP words, recommendations, Jesus. That's Serb, not me.
What?
I don't know. Probably.
A dark force growing inside my mind? What the hell was he talking about?
That can't be me. That
attention, everybody. Serb was watching pony videos.
Right.
I wasn't watching that shit on the...
I wasn't watching that. Oh, man. Not me.
Sort of like how I went into your the K-Zone channel, and I saw in the search Sam Hyde advice videos.
I like watching those as background noise. They're fun. He just like, it's like eight. So here's the thing with those videos.
Go for it.
It's like 8 minutes, and the title will be like, Sam tells you how to make the big bucks or something like that. And it'll be like eight, like 4 minutes of him like eating, and it'll just be like a guy calling in with a question where it's like, hey, Sam, a huge fan here. I make $200,000 a year and I'm 24 years old. How can I make more money? And Sam will just kind of go, yeah, you should just keep doing that, man.
You get enough sleep.
You get enough sleep. You drink. Yeah. You just keep doing that, man.
Just make sure you don't get any seed oils in your diet.
Just make sure you don't drink out of the tap. Just make sure you don't talk to girls. He had that like skinny fat Zoomer with him for a while. Who I don't know. I think he's like a Zoomer rapper or something.
Jet Neptune.
Do you know him?
He did Fish Tag. He was the producer for Fish Tag.
Oh, man.
And people, he would do like the most responsible thing. I remember there was that. Did you watch any of Fish Tag?
Okay, tell me about Fish Tag, because I only saw little clips. I know that they were just letting like insane people in.
They did the second season was nothing. No cultural impact.
Oh.
The first season was interesting because like you had six people who I thought didn't know who Sam Hyde was.
Right.
Which would have been perfect. But they fucked up by having two people be the plants. Mm-hmm. And one of them kept on like spoiling it by bringing his phone into the fish tank room and like the house and whatever. So yeah. It was obvious he was the plant.
Right.
So that just turned out that just like ruined a lot of it. And then there was a Simmons guy who was an ESL guy who everyone else found out about him.
Right.
That he wrote a book on how to date campers.
Oh, that's right. I heard about this. Yeah.
And then he publicly outs him and kicks him out of the house. And everyone else feels really uncomfortable. There was the autistic guy, the autistic retard guy. he started freaking out because he was dehydrated because he doesn't drink water and would only drink coffee all day.
Oh my god!
So they gave him beer and weed, and he started freaking out and breaking things.
Oh my god!
And everyone got mad at Jet Neptune for cutting the cameras for a night because everyone was just. Really shaken up from being so close to a supposed pedophile for so long. That's... So everyone was like, "Fuck you, Jet! You ruined the content." It's like, dude, like,
God. The second season had the guy who wouldn't stop punching women or something. It was something like that, right? Yeah.
I think he won because everyone loved him for that.
Oh man, Jesus Christ! They just had the, they had like the autistic guy who could not stop punching girls.
Because they broke his push and play phone, which is very funny. Very funny reason to hit a woman.
Very just God. That's. I did. She was swinging at me. And everyone's like, no, man, no. He was kicked off the show and then brought back on because, oh my God.
Because.
No, yeah, sorry, go ahead.
They brought on the Mr. Beast lookalike.
What?
You know, like the fake Mr. Beast from the Epic Rap Battles of History?
No.
There's the fake Mr. Beast, and they brought him on the show, and they tormented him the entire time, looks which like is I've very good.
That's
that
awesome.
That was the only good part, I think, of season two. And
the fake Mr. Beast.
Coincided alongside when Frank Hassel was in the house, and he would just get tormented by him.
What the hell is that supposed to be?
He broke down crying after they ruined his Mr. Beast shirt.
Oh, no.
Oh, great. These guys again.
No fucking way, you pieces of shit.
Hey, it's Vince. It's Vince Desi.
I like the part where, when Sam was first coming into the house, he would just start assaulting cabinets with his boxing gloves.
Oh, yeah.
Don't suppose you'd be willing to lend a hand.
Listen, man, I'd love to help, but nothing's free. Tell you what, I've got some action I could throw your way. Take care of this for me, and I'll see what I can do. Come on, I'll tell you all about it at my church.
It's my boy Vince.
Wait, you have a church?
All right, here we are, the Gamergate day.
This is the Gamergate day. This is the one thing that we have to make sure we hit on.
Absolutely. We've got Gamergate art in here, too.
There you are, dude.
Really?
Yes.
To be honest, there was some terrible racket going on all night.
Forget Did Sam Hyde ever, like, say anything about Gamergate while it went down?
Anyway, I don't think so.
I think that was the one, like, very politically motivated time period where he was just not involved.
That's because MDE was still good back then.
Now about Champ.
Mm.
No problem, man. I know the secret for how you can find Champ and cure him of his monstrous condition. Before you know it, you'll both be happy and healthy.
Actually, about that.
I've still got this bullet in my head, and it seems to be affecting my
voice. Yeah, the Postal 3, dude.
Some psychotic alternate persona's slowly taken over my mind, and...
Enough of that. I'll tell you the secret of finding Champ once you take care of a few things. Here, you'll need this map fragment to guide
you. You know about Jace Connors, right, sir?
No.
So he was like... I'll explain in a sec.
Church is running low on toilet paper. And we're not about to start using our hands.
It's a wonderful story.
Gets messy around here. The store's right here. My boys have developed a hot new game that's poised to take the town by storm. Deliver these motherboards to the local arcade so the public can enjoy it. There's the arcade. But it turns
now
out
you can get to the arcade.
Now.
Are trying to develop a cheap ripoff of our game. Pay them a visit and liquidate some of their gear for us. And those assholes are over there.
They're over there.
Get your ass out there and don't. All right,
so Deagle Nation was like a guy who I think had Kiwi Farms fooled for years. Like he was pretending to just be this crazy guy, and he was like to the point where his mother would answer the phone and like use the name that he had given her, and he had friends writing fake information for like about him on Kiwi Farms for years.
That's cool, because I've always wondered what would happen if you did something like that.
Oh, yeah, no, just made his entire life, like, fiction for a couple of years. But the thing that really, like, the thing that kind of brought him more into prominence was when he crashed his car and took out his phone and said that he was coming to kill Brianna Wu during Gamergate.
That's awesome.
He said that she had sent an assassin... to take him out on the way.
Oh my God.
Hey, look, the Gamergate art.
Where's more of it? Is it just that?
It might just be that, but you could never really own. Those avatars were in vogue back then. But God, what an amazing time to be on the computer.
They had like the what's it called? What's the name of it? The Daily Dose colors.
Oh, Jesus, that's right. Oh, man. All the art that they did of, like, Vivian James, and it was like...
You remember Gamergate Life?
That was still going for, like, a bizarrely long time. Like, even long after Gamergate had finished, Gamergate Life was still going.
I remember the most popular one was the Hulk Hogan Gawker one.
Oh, man. What a weird thing. Yeah, Gamergate Life was a webcomic that I think just kept going. Do you remember your Daily Dose, Rocky? Oh, of course.
Okay, I have a... So people know what you're talking about. Do you mind if I send you a...
Please do, yes. Any images that you can send that will jog my memory, by all means.
Hold on. Oh, wait, I gotta tap it right here.
Look how loud this rain sound is. I wonder what they do on Kotaku in action now. Well,
I could check. You don't have to worry. I'll check.
Because I remember there was back when I was like 18 or 19, I used to like Tumblr in action. But that was mostly just reacting to like a 14-year-old being like, yo, I think my gender is like a cloud or something. And now you go on there and it's just like, it was just like wall-to-wall turf shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Kotaku in action. Yeah. See that comic right there?
All right. Oh, you sent it. Let's have a look at this. All right.
Oh, right. I know something.
Hang on. I'm trying to make sense of what the hell this says. Stand against censorship. We have Gamergate posters to sell. Go home, gamer girl.
The Logan Paul episode.
Did you know they have been? What the fuck? Wait, am I reading this the wrong way? Was this made by someone who didn't speak English?
I don't know.
Who is the red girl?
I think that's the red SJW.
Is there a lore to this?
I don't know.
I think this is made by someone who doesn't speak English. Yeah, I'm staring at this. I'm trying to figure out if there's a joke or... I simply don't understand. All right, we got a video. Hold on. Are you ready?
Yeah, go for it.
Oh, yeah, you're about to understand why Tim Schafer's in this game.
I think you'll agree with me.
Yes!
Tonight I will not be making any jokes about Gamergate. All of tonight's Gamergate jokes will be made by this sock puppet.
Oh, man.
The concept of a sock puppet account, I don't think people were sock puppets.
I think they were mad at you, Tim.
I think they didn't like you.
I cannot be held responsible for anything the sock puppet says. It's not associated with me at all. Hello! This is going to be great.
I found Law & Order SVU on Gamers, H3 reaction video.
So how about it? Got any good Gamergate stuff for me tonight? Hell yeah.
Dude, I'm looking at like...
He's telling his joke.
I don't know. How do you know the Gamergate is dead? The reproductively inactive workers are able to become reproductive again. What? Hey, why did the Gamergate cut off her sister's thoracic Jimmy? What? They aggressively broadcast competitiveness and reproductive viability. Oh, I see what's going on here. I brought the wrong sock puppet. This is the fact sock puppet for the Gamergate ant.
What?
I should have known by the antenna. It's a real thing. Look it up. That was a long walk for ant jokes. Okay. Those actually weren't even jokes. Don't you know any actual jokes? Okay, how did the immature worker become dominant in the colony? I don't know. They slept with an IGF judge.
I can forgive you because you made Grim Fandango.
I think we've all had it up to here with
Nah, man, forgiveness is for God.
And, no more collusion. I know a lot of people like to make conversations about award shows that you have to sleep with the right people to win, and I want to assure everybody that's not the case tonight. Tonight's awards were judged completely fairly. I slept with everybody.
What?
Oh, man.
Yes.
Thinking Man poster says, I heard Psychonauts 2 is good.
I don't know.
I am pretty tired, and it's a little awkward to make eye contact with everybody out here right now.
Sakaguchi-san. But it's worth it. Everybody gets equal treatment, although bad news for some, performance will be
I like the first one. It's a very 2005 Invader Zim type
of
game.
Sorry about that, Cliff. Okay. On with the show, shall we? If you love video games, let me hear you say, I love video games.
I love video games!
I love video games!
If you love developers, let me hear you say, I love developers.
I love developers!
I love developers!
Players, let me hear you say, I love the players. If you love the publishers, get the hell out of here, that's sick. These are the Game Developers Choice Awards, so let's get to it.
Oh, man.
All right. Oh. That's so sweet. There's a little note for me on the teleprompter from the Crystal, the teleprompter operator. It says, best day.
All right,
so
Kotaku
nice.
In action.
That was a nice intro.
All right. What do you got?
It's not my first time here.
I'm going to go to top all time.
That's the name of the
award. Oh, please
okay.
do.
First award, best debut.
There's two kinds of people. Oh,
making
it's...
Making games is a lot like making waffles.
Oh, wow.
They're created under intense pressure. They taste better if they're not full of bugs. And you always mess up the first one you make. That's just like a rule of thumb. You always burn it or peek
that's
in it too
fine.
Much
like,
or you don't test it
this
enough,
is the thing most people like Malco Brackley says when I was
everybody
in middle school
it.
Around this time and I used to look
Throw
at Tumblr in action and thought South
experience.
Park tackling SJWs
well,
was the funniest thing ever. I wasn't super into the rabbit hole
memo.
Where I watched Sargon
their
of Akkad or old Chris
were,
Reagan. I was more of a dumbass ignorant kid, but I was close to falling into that trap. People do this, they're like, I had a Nazi phase, and it's like, no, did you go to Unite the Right, or does your political journey begin and end with calling Ian Miles Chong a homo?
Yeah, seriously. As long as you're not, you get out of there, and you're not, like, doubling and tripling down. I've talked to people that, like, you know, were in that scene back then. And they said that, like, either you keep on doubling and tripling down until you're on the SPLC website, or you hesitate and stop doubling and tripling down, and then your supposed friends dox you.
How many irritators does it take to make a single piece of armor? Oh, God, I don't know. 50! One to do the modeling.
Yeah, I think Gamergate happened when I was, like, 19, and then I got a job, and I stopped giving a shit.
Again, I cannot be blamed for what the puppet
it was
says.
Funny though.
The point is the standard for art is
that's the thing. I don't have to like you don't have to do the thing where you're like, oh, I just really hated myself and I was just like, no, it was funny.
Stretch I get paid by the
not doing the whole iDubbbz thing. Yeah.
No, it was funny,
you.
But I have a job and responsibilities now.
Yeah, the overcorrection of iDubbbz.
Oh, I just hate I really hated myself. But Rocky,
so you wanna do the...
Oh, hang on. Wait, we have the Jace. I have to give context to Jace Connors. This is the video.
Oh, YouTube, this is Jace right here, and this is my fucking car, or my mom's car, that when I was straight racing,
crushed my pocket, hey, Rock.
Couldn't fucking perform on the road, and now I'm getting shit as crush, okay? I can't even kick the windshield because it's being bullshit, but I can't I was just racing, you know, like normal. I was trying to scream this fucking highlight. Remember that bullshit? Remember that shit? Totally useless. I hit and I fucking rolled on the ice. Fucking rolled down here. And now look at this piece of shit.
Oh my god.
I'm a scream racing god! Fuck! I'm a scream racing god! And this is all because Marvin and Rusty's terrorists. You fucking made me do this, and this isn't my fault. And just cause the road was slippery doesn't mean I'm as straight as a gun! And I'm fucking right out there!
Well, I love him.
I love him. Straight racers!
This is incredible.
This is why I say it is the funniest thing to ever happen online.
You know, it's funny because there were people that actually kind of did think like this. Not to this extreme, but just like the absolute derangement.
Oh man.
This was there.
This, I should probably explain, this is the exact point at which the internet became real life. Like, when you went on, you used to go on the internet and you'd understand that it was not a real place.
Yeah.
This is so good. You don't even know.
The counter-journalism campaign will uncover shocking facts. Ready to begin phase two.
Phase two.
My co-journalist, Elijah.
Oh, man.
Oh, yeah, Brianna Wu is pro-Israel to, like, an extreme degree.
I'll explain Brianna Wu in just a moment.
Do people not know?
They're like, well, I didn't know she was an idiot. It's like, what? Jeez. U.S. retired armed forces. I don't know. I have a bit of an admiration for Brianna Wu just because of her, like, fake it till you make it kind of attitude.
Are you talking about how she never breaks kayfabe about being trans?
Well, that is also, that's a generation thing. That's like, even if, like, she's like, what, 45? Yeah, even if someone sticks a gun in your face, you're not supposed to, like, say you're trans. That's just a generational thing. But, like, her insisting that she was, like a really accomplished game developer when her game was Revolution 60. And actually, getting like invited to tech conferences and stuff, where people in the audience, these like autistic STEM guys, would be like, "I don't know what you're talking about," and she'd be like, "Oh, you're mansplaining to me right now what I'm talking about." Just complete fake it till you make it type shit. She's awesome. She is awesome. And like her thing with Israel is like she's Googled Israel and then it's like, all right, I'm an expert.
She basically does the Destiny thing.
Pretty much, yeah.
What do you think about that debate?
Which one?
The one where you just got steamrolled by Finkelstein.
Man, that was. I don't know. I mean, there's no. Like bottom of the pit for people like that, because the people talking about them is money for them.
Oh yeah.
So I don't know. I mean, he's like, he's debating Sean King now, which is kind of like if you die enough times in Devil May Cry, it unlocks easy difficulty.
Yeah.
Like.
it was great. That debate was great because he was just called a hobo by an old man for like
having an old Jewish man being like, "You are ridiculous. You are the most ridiculous man I've ever met in my life." That's just beautiful.
Getting yelled at by being called a homo by the trumpet guy.
You are moronic.
Who are you? Who are you?
Who are you? My mother could beat the game if she saved as much as you do. All right, we're at PU Games.
So that's the bank.
Well, it was the bank.
It's time to carry out a little corporate warfare.
All right. Oh God! Kill these game developers.
They're a hate group in game.
Yes. The game devs.
Don't you have? No, you should use your explosives.
Oh yeah, what am I doing? Don't come to PU Games tomorrow, everyone.
Dropkick them.
Oh yeah. So. One of the things that kind of is cool about Postal 2 is every single object has like physics and gravity and stuff, so you can just kick stuff.
Yep.
Which you should, because throwing things is fucking useless in this game. Throwing objects, not so good. Kicking it, very good.
I don't know what the dynamite works for.
Yeah, the dynamite's a new weapon that got patched in, so it's kind of buggy
and
shitty. I debated Destiny about Israel. Who the fuck are you? That's beautiful.
Who the fuck are you? Who are you? I brought Lex Fridman up on stage. Fuck it.
Fuck it. Damn. They still update this? Yeah, they do.
A lot more than you'd think.
Come see our amazing... Oh, here we go. Balls out. Stalker, clear your aisle. Okay. Equality simulator. Oh.
Here we go. There we go.
Oh, there we go. Finally, some jokes.
That was everything. All right, here we go.
This is, a game that got abandoned by Double... They're making fun of Double Fine, which is very weird, because Double Fine are an indie developer. Meh, it's good enough. Lattes are expensive, you know? So this still came... This came out, like, back when people still did real photo reference for, like, textures. So I love... This is one of my favorite things in, like, games of this era.
Oh, my God!
It's just, like... Someone had to take a picture of, like, a fridge.
I think you can see them in the reflection. Look down at the bottom of that.
Probably. God.
I see Crisco.
Yeah, there's just Crisco. Yeah, it's just like back when like you had to just photo reference textures, so pizza looks like pizza.
The Reddit. What's that?
That's the postal website.
Oh, I thought that was r/watchpeopledie. Do you remember the era of the internet where there would just be like, fat people hate was such an insane.
Oh man, yeah, the people. Well, it's like, people read that and then they devote their entire life like to it. It can happen in any community. It can be a community where you decide that you don't like, I don't know, children, for example.
r/child-free.
That's awesome. Pre-order exclusive DLC, day one pack. Awesome. Is that Comic Sans?
Probably.
Hell yes. So glad. You pull the book, but nothing happened? Oh.
Oh, I think you can actually get inside that. I think that's a...
Oh boy, here we go.
I hate how that looks.
Oh my god. You're killing him. You're doing it. Yeah, so they've just got like, yeah, see Crack-A-Cola, there you go.
I think you buy some of that, actually.
You can.
That's now an item.
Yeah, I think they. We're killing these game developers.
That's the stuff.
Go home, gamer girl.
Go home, gamer. Make sure you follow and subscribe, by the way.
We make a lot of it. We always regurgitate the point where,
Yeah.
You know, Reddit used to have like a fucking like a jailbait thing, like, very pro pedophilia website.
Oh yeah. Well, they used to be like free, like libertarian free speech people, and that meant having, yeah, the jailbait board that was like the most popular thing on the site.
Truly insane.
No, that's just a period in time online. They were just like,
oh. It was, but it's like looking back now, it's crazy.
Yeah. Yeah, they used to just have the snuff subreddit stayed around for a lot longer than I like thought it would have.
r/watch people die.
Yeah, and it's exactly what it says. But the combat footage one entirely, like, I don't know if you've been on the game, if she saved as much as you, if you've been on like World News or the news subreddits, they are so blatantly like slid. In terms of like what is talked about, like you're not allowed to be like, oh yeah, no, Israel blew up 150 people today.
Because of like the moderation now, or
oh, because yeah, well the mods are Ghislaine Maxwell was a mod of Reddit.
Oh, I didn't know that.
You didn't know that.
I thought it was just bullshit.
No, that was true. She was a moderator on Reddit. It's entire, yeah, what's the term? AstroTurfed, that's it.
See if you can break the, like, vending machine back. That's the ticket. That might count.
I'm not sure, I gotta find more stuff to shoot. But, yeah, no, that so much of that is just, like... There were reports of people going on, I think, 8chan and trying to turn them against Russia, and they were intelligence agents.
Really?
Yeah, that was in one of their reports. And they were just like... Huh. Yeah, it's crazy.
Do you think that we're gonna find out that like Wojaks are like used to like turn people against things?
Wojaks are used by grown men because they're too embarrassed to play with dolls.
That's true.
I don't want to talk about the weird woke Wojaks again. Those were so bizarre, but they come back.
Oh my God.
They come back every election season.
I love them. I hope they stay forever.
Those strange Wojaks where they had real hair and real human ears.
I love them.
Those were so fucking weird. Didn't you just save? like... Oh, that wasn't what I was meant to do. But, yeah, they come back every single election season, and they're the most, like, obscure conflicts. Like, you're seeing, like...
It was like the ones where it was like, you will just find the interracial, like, feuds that you never knew about. Like, yeah, the ones that were, against Somalians.
Well, the ones that are about black Americans being against Jamaicans. And the argument, which, like, that's, damn.
I like, the amount of racism that spawned from that was insane.
That's you're learning about, like, it's lucky that we can't get into, like, the Balkan internet, because the way that, like, they post about each other is apparently, like, the reason for example that 2chan you're not allowed to post on it outside of Japan is to prevent Koreans from going on it.
Wow.
Yeah, that, like,
well, there's a TV I think you could break. Turn around.
Yeah.
Oh, no. Man. They don't make enough shit breakable.
No, they don't. I have to break all this shit, apparently.
Oh, little towers? Yeah.
Maybe.
Yeah, little towers, too.
Boy, this is they really playtested this, and it was fun. But, all right,
get the computer tower.
Yeah, Japan and Korea, those are, like, crazy flame wars. Usually it'll be like a VTuber. Well, in terms of those, like, wars that you see online, it'll be like, I know VTubers get in trouble if they acknowledge Taiwan, for example.
Oh, yeah, because there's a lot of money in, like, when it comes to, like, the Chinese market for VTubers. They love their chubas over there.
They do. But that's, they're not just like, oh, you know, we're going to cancel. It's like, no, we will kill you. Like, we will... They're really, really bizarrely focused with that shit over there. They're, like, posting pictures of, like, you know, the Japanese ones have, like, pictures of people ripping up their manga and stuff. How the fuck do I get in here?
Are you supposed to?
I don't know.
Because I remember it said, you pull a book, but nothing happens.
One of the things, like, the aesthetic of this game, the thing that interests me about it is that it is mundane. Like, I'm sure you've noticed this by now. If you're watching this, there is no background music to this game.
Oh, yeah.
There is no background music. Settings are just boring real places. And I don't know. It's weird when you get to Postal 4. Is this... Can I blow this up? You get to, like, Postal 4, and it's, like, wacky. Oh, there we go. All right. Oh, I was meant to blow that up. Mission accomplished
with extreme... I guess all the, what's it fucking called? All the grenades near it was all the sun.
Yeah. Alright, now we have to go fight Tim Schafer.
Why'd they make you just, like, do that, like, dog and pony show of, like, fucking...
Shooting the computers? Oh, here we go.
That's his real face, by the way.
Yes, that is a texture of Tim Schafer's face. What? That brief meh sound.
I love him. I mean, just the fact, I just love how they designed him. He's just a small, fat guy. I love it. What's going on?
I'll kill you! I just love that they were like, you know who needs to be taken down a peg? A fellow indie. A guy who got greedy by making 2 Kickstarters and delivering on both of them. Well, we did it. We killed Tim Schafer, everybody.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, Tim Schafer.
I'm gonna plunder the vault.
Oh, we shall.
Get all those donuts.
I did, of course. Ooh, brandy.
That stuff really works.
Shiny cube.
ADDgamers.net.
That's pretty good. Yo, they kept these in here. Oh, man.
Here they are. Those... Hey, why is Mr. Schafer, such a fan of Fag Hunter?
Oh, man, the hidden... That's like a really weird example of Running With Scissors censoring themselves, because Fag Hunter got patched out with Share the Pain. So that's a weird case.
There was no internet told them to do that then, right?
Nope.
They are very weirdly kind to gay people. They're Q Republicans. But I remember someone was telling me anecdotes about, like, how they fired someone.
That was me. That was, yeah, no, I had a friend who was a QA tester for one of their games, and they fired someone for sending them Troon Jacks. Fucking. There you go. They just fired him on the, yeah, they just goes like, see ya.
Interesting. It's so, I love it when people are like, lands of contrast like that.
Oh, it's funny. Oh, by the way, the water physics in this are really interesting.
Now the flowers will grow.
Wow!
Yeah, you weren't expecting,
wow.
Yeah, look at that. Hey, yeah.
I'm glad they kept it, because that's awesome. Did you unlock the graveyard yet?
I don't know.
Because there's something, there's a really funny NPC you could find there.
Is that true? Alright, we'll go to the graveyard.
Yeah.
Actually, yeah, if we have the church, we have the graveyard.
Yeah, go to the graveyard.
So, something else about this game. Guys won't be too pleased the next time we meet. I'll explain. Better stay in just a moment. Is the liquid physics in this are the most, like, impressive I think I've ever seen in any, like, a game.
Now this one?
Flowers, yeah. It's a really sophisticated liquid physics. It's they couldn't replicate it for Postal 4.
Oh, and, you mean like the piss?
Well, see, okay, so here's obviously how this came about. They needed gasoline to be pourable. And then, you know, so you do like that, and then you light it up. But then obviously some developer thought, okay, what if you could piss? And that's kind of why I like Postal 2. I like the original Postal 2 a lot, is because it does have a lot of that, like, making a game with your friends kind of feel to it.
Yeah.
Like, you're just like, ah, what if you could piss in your own mouth? Like, watch this.
You know, that's actually, like, a strat for, like, the hardest difficulty.
Yes.
In the game,
yes.
That you have to pee on yourself constantly, because all your enemies will have, like, insane weapons.
Yes. This game also turns into a stealth game on the hardest difficulty, and one of the strats is to pee in people's faces until they vomit. But, like, I'll show you what I mean. Let's go find a cop. Hold on. Are you ready? I don't know if you can do it in this, hold on. Take my money. How do I bribe him? Oh, hang on, I gotta zip my pants up. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay, so one of the things you can do in this game. Ah, shit, didn't I just give him my money?
Yeah.
Oh. I did. He took my money.
All of it?
Yes. Oh, I guess it won't work. So one of the things you can do in the base game that makes this game an immersive sim, you can drop a donut, pee on it. If a cop eats it, they are attracted. Cops are attracted to donuts. They will pick up the donut and eat it, and they will vomit.
You also get an achievement.
Yes. That's like one of those things where it's just like...
This game had very fun achievements.
Yes. Like, they just had someone on the team who was like, wouldn't it be funny if you peed on a donut and a cop picked it up and ate it? So they programmed that in.
The toilet store.
The toilet store. The wipe house. Jeez. Sparing no expense. Welcome to the wipe
house. How may I wipe? I like how he's behind a cage, like a gas station in like a shitty part of town.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Test the urinals. Do they let? I want to read this. Says that you're allowed to test them.
I do just like that. Like they had like an asset for a toilet and they just dumped it everywhere.
No, go to the urinal.
I will. I'm in line, sir. Welcome to
the
White House.
How may I wipe you today? That's the ticket.
Beautiful. Shut up.
Oh, you got. I love it when you're in like the toilet store. There's just cats, stray cats running around.
But yeah, a lot of the, like, you can just play like the base game by just doing whatever. You just go do your tasks. And all of the NPCs in the game are just like antagonistic towards you. They're just rude. Which is so good.
198 viewers at top end, by the way. We have like 190.
Oh, I have no money. 198 viewers. Jesus Christ. Make sure you follow. Make sure you subscribe or gift a sub. Yeah, I like that they have like scripting for the like cashier, so it's like that'll be $28.
Oh yeah, I love that.
That'll be $36. Definitely need more of that. Yeah, it's cool. It's cool when games do that.
They put in a lot of effort just for the thing that people are going to be most compelled to skip.
Yeah, exactly. That'll be $22. Understands me. Like just clearly like okay sure you don't have to be violent, and that was their defense when the game started getting like banned in countries. It was like, well, you don't have to be.
Do you think that they had that in mind while they're making it, like they completely telegraphed
No, it actually pissed them off a lot because people wanted to buy the game and they couldn't. So basically
the defense though that you couldn't be, they don't have to be violent. What I mean.
I don't think so. So the reason that like Postal 2, the original, the satire of that game is in response to murder simulators and Columbine. Postal 2 is a murder simulator. It is that's a word that got thrown around a lot back then after Columbine, and people were very critical of violence in games. But they basically made the closest thing to like a mass shooting in the real world as a game could back then. Like you're in a real world setting. Like a fairly realistic for the time setting. You're not on a spaceship. You're not, you know, fighting demons on Mars or anything. You're in a real place and you can just murder people. So it was made specifically to antagonize the mainstream media. That's where a lot of the satire of the original game comes from. But that's also why Postal 4 is fucking stupid. Because why does that game exist?
It was a satire.
What is that game? What's that game satirizing?
It's like, oh, there's pizza on the floor. There's poop pizza. Go get the poop pizza.
I saw the poop pizza. But, yeah, it was made to piss off Lieberman. There's an arcade in the original game called Lieberman's Arcade.
There's a difficulty called Lieber Mode.
Yeah, and it makes everyone have shovels.
Shit.
Like, one of the levels in Postal 2 is just Waco.
Oh, yeah. Your Uncle Dave.
Yeah, your Uncle Dave. Yeah, you're in the middle of Waco and you're shooting the ATF.
There you go. Oh, I thought you were gonna be able to get the quick way out.
No, if I had done the catnip, maybe. But like, yeah, Postal 4 is weird because it's not satire. I hate to use that fucking image of, you know, satire requires clarity, or about like, what the fuck is that game satirizing?
Yeah, no, it was just, I guess they just wanted to make another one, but they didn't realize that they, you know, it's very sauceless.
It's entirely, yeah, it is entirely sauceless. There's no through line of anything with it. It's entered the thing with franchises where it's just shaped like itself.
Like that's a good way of putting it.
Franchises eventually have this thing where, you know, they just they start just referencing themselves. You can see it here too. Like one of the satirical things in Postal 2 is that the developers are characters in the game and you can go kill them.
Right.
That's like obviously this is very blasé now, but like I played this game when it came out, and it was... I mean, I played Postal 2 when it came out, and it's nuts. It was crazy. I had never seen a game like that before. Like, a game where you could just... Like, yeah, it was provocative. It was intended to be provocative.
I love the level structure they have here. Girl.
Yeah, it's great. Awesome. For the toilet paper store.
This can't be good for me.
Yeah, devs love putting themselves into games so this time. Like, you had... It's... Postal 2 is a very special game.
There will never be another like it. They tried, doesn't work.
You
out.
Can't do it, because Postal 2 is...
Nothing about its time period. It was created in that way.
It was a... Maybe a perfect time capsule of America after 9/11. All of the terrorists in the game look like Osama bin Laden. They are all just Osama bin Laden. And you can literally go to Tora Bora and kill Osama bin Laden in Postal 2.
That's right, there's a terrorist camp.
Yes.
Isn't that part of Apocalypse Weekend?
No, that was Share the Pain. That got patched in. You could go to Tora Bora and kill Osama.
Oh, that's from going in the sewers.
Yep, right behind your house. But, yeah, it is a very, very interesting game. And they've tried to replicate it. They're trying to replicate it here, and they can't quite do it. Because this is like a post-apocalyptic setting. It's a silly setting. Postal 2 is mundane. It is a mundane setting. But you do boring tasks, and the thing that makes the game exciting is that you are able to just murder people.
And pee on them. So, did you hear about this new Nickelodeon documentary that's been going around?
Have you seen this? Have you heard about this? Yeah, I have. What do you think about it, sir? I've been rambling. I'm sorry. You go ahead.
Oh, no, you're fine. I find it, like, insane that after all these years, like going on like TV and having Dan the Candyman Schneider and all that stuff,
Dan,
and having it just be imperceptible to like everyone, and then suddenly it is
Dan the Demolition Man Schneider.
Yep.
Dan and then, the and beer then the, can Schneider.
And in a crossover, it's like also Drake Bell's involved, and he was turbo molested as a kid.
Yeah, so that's basically the end stage of something everyone knew was true a decade ago, like finally being delivered to like normies. Like they have to, like I watched a bit of the first episode, they have to have like a lady come on and be like, we call this a toxic workplace, you know? This was a toxic workplace. And it's like, no, like this is the only way that you can like explain this to people. That most people, like, you know, something everyone kind of understands to be true, which is that every single child actor got molested. And most of the people who worked for, like, Nickelodeon in the 90s were, like, insane.
It's either you're being molested, or a molester, or you're aiding and abetting a molester.
Yeah, it's, wow. Wait until you find out about Hollywood.
Yeah, really?
Wow.
Who would have thought?
Who would have thought? But... I remember joking about like Dan Schneider a decade ago when they were like people found a tweet where he had a pool toy that was shaped like a slice of pizza, and he had a dog whose name was Loli. I shit you.
I didn't know about the dog part. That's fucked up.
He was not hiding it. Loli, as in candy, by the way, but not like. But still, even then.
That's actually somehow worse.
That's bizarre, right?
Yeah, no, it's ugh. I saw that one tweet where he ran the contest like right iCarly on your feet and sent it to this Twitter.
Yeah, he was not subtle. If you watched 5 minutes of iCarly, you could absolutely tell from just the way he shoots those teenage girls. I don't even think they were teenagers. I think they were like 12. But like, yeah, there's an episode of iCarly that I remember where they're putting chocolate sauce on their feet and the camera just gets these lingering close-ups. And I'm like, is this okay? This feels weird.
I remember there was an entire episode.
Oh, it's in the mall. What am I doing? I'm lost.
As a kid, there was an entire subplot where Carly gets her foot or her big toe stuck in a faucet. And that was the entire B-plot.
Yeah, that's Dan the Man.
None of this was prevalent in Drake and Josh, which I mean, it's kind of obvious as I'm talking through it because that show didn't center around teenage girl actors.
Yeah, that's someone send in that clip where Josh is in that movie and he's being really homophobic, please. If you could submit that, I don't know what that movie's
I'll
called. It's the funniest clip in the world. But like. Yeah, most of that stuff is like you go back and you watch Ren and Stimpy, and that like half that show is just John Kay like talking about being a pedophile.
Mean Creek Dare scene.
Yes, please. I know what you're talking about. Please, if you do, my goodness.
Oh, we have another video shared.
Oh, we do.
Gonna...
Yes, please play that clip of Josh swearing. That's your stupid fucking dad. Yes. I hope your dad dies of fag AIDS. It's so good.
I got you.
All right, let's go. No, those places.
You don't have to.
All right, yeah, no, go for it. Go for it.
Marty. Trisoner.
There.
All right. I dare you to pull down your pants and your underwear and show us that famous dick of yours for at least 10 seconds.
Oh, 10 seconds. Wow, you are a killer, Sam. All right, I will do it because I am proud of my boys. But if I do, I don't want anyone else wimping out on their dares.
So let's see the penis. Bring on the penis. All
right. Oh, wasn't that? That was also a good one.
Yeah, send the full clip in.
If anyone could beat me to it, I'm gonna look for it. Josh Peck's dirty mouth.
Yes, please. It's spherical. All
right, this is an edited over. The scene might be gone.
Oh no! Did they get rid of the original scene?
The video I just put Josh Peck homophobic.
Please.
But it's not there. But there's this other video called Josh Peck's Dirty Mouth.
Yeah, do it. That's the one. That's probably it.
Well, no, it's not the actual scene, but we hear Josh saying the lines.
No,
from that.
It has to be the scene from that movie because it is so funny to hear him saying that.
All right.
Please try and find it, sir, if you can.
Oh, is it? Yep.
You got it? You got it?
Oh my god, yep, I found it. It took a little bit.
There you go. God, this level design is so cramped and awful.
I don't know why they did that. There was no reason for them to do that.
Alright, roll that footage, sir. Let's go.
Oh man, there's two video donations. What's this one?
Oh my god.
Oh, he has that one. Okay.
So all right, go, yes. Oh no.
Did not work?
Hang on. Wait.
No, but I have this one. This one is basically it.
Hang on. Let's go. Come on.
Is locked this... in your country?
Hang on. I'll play it. I don't. We have the video, so I'll Josh Peck in Mead Creek.
Thank you, Trenchman Vor.
Thank you so much. We're going to play it for you. Yes. Here it is. Okay, hang on. Ready? One sec. All right. Here we go.
And speaking of dead fathers, I just remembered my bonehead. White trash fucking dog.
No, this isn't the full scene. God damn it, we need to find the full one. What's it called? Hang on. Wait. Josh Peck in Mead Creek has a confrontation. Yes. Why can't I not? Okay, Josh Peck.
Apparently his character fucking dies.
Yes, he does. That's what that movie's about. Josh Peck in Mead Creek confrontation. I'm trying to find this. Yes. Oh, shit. Why is it so hard to find the full scene?
Oh, my God.
Yes, here it is. Okay.
Marty, I was just messing around with you.
Okay, messing boy. I dare you to strip buck naked and jump in the river.
You're not sorry. I'm sorry.
Let's just watch the whole movie.
Is at this point.
Your birthday?
No.
Is that? Oh, we got it.
We got it.
Shit. You're a fucking lying son of a bitch, Sam, all right? And I hope you fucking go to hell.
Don't make things worse, George.
Shut the fuck up, Millie, you fucking stupid chap cunt. Shut the fuck up, Clyde, you faggot. Fucking skinny, butt-munching faggot. I hate you, you know that? I really do. Because all you do is fucking prance around school talking about your fucking faggoty fairy fathers. I'll tell you what, I don't want to hear about your fucking fathers and how their assholes work, all right? It makes me sick. And I fucking hope they fucking die of fag disease. Yeah. And speaking of dead fathers, I just remembered my bonehead, white trash fucking donkey dick Marty got so fucking freaked when I started talking about his daddy. He's Neanderthal.
Is there more cursing?
Put a gun in.
Oh, never mind. This is just the movie. We're not watching the movie. We're watching Josh Peck be homophobic.
That's that. Let's deliver these games. I want to see the arcade.
Oh, yes. Do we have... Hang on.
We do have a video.
We do have a video. What is this? Getting some water.
I remember this. This is a throwback. For some people... Some people remember Ghost, right?
I'm a melting pot of friendship!
He's still around today. I remember. Alright. What, So, something that, I remember one of the first 4chan adjacent things I ever had when I was a kid was, my friend showed me Ghost crank call videos back when bronies would call him and just like play songs from it, and he gets so fucking mad. His whole shtick is irrelevant now because it's like conservative Twitter now. Yeah, no, it was no, like what changed is that everyone just on Twitter, everyone like just fucking agrees with me. No one really makes fun of conservatives anymore, really. And like, well, they do, but not in like a neutral nerd circle. There's not much of like a neutral nerd circle anymore where you just fucking like, like, I remember the very first time like Christian got made fun of was because he was homophobic and like backwards and racist. That, and he was a weird Coke bottle glass store nerd. But, yeah. You don't really get people fucking with Ghost anymore because people disagree with him now.
You don't get good cranks anymore.
Yeah, no, you don't.
Oh, what a beautiful time. Alright, back to the game.
Fuck off.
Flipping people off is actually a tactic in the hardest difficulty in this again.
Too. Yes, it is. You can.
Fuck you.
It stuns them.
Yeah,
it
briefly
said.
Yeah.
On a swivel, and they just like fucking go to town.
This is so awful to navigate. You have no idea how bad to navigate this level is.
I'm watching you. I know, because we're not getting in the arcade, and
I have been trying.
They shouldn't have made it this difficult.
Why is this level so weird and complex? Is this
I think
it?
You have to go into a different area.
Cute puppy.
Fuck you, buddy.
I think you have to enter in a different area.
I can't remember. It's
there was like
I like that they have all this empty space in the level now. Look at this. See, the thing in the original game is you just have sections like this where it is just mundane. There's no real reason to come in here.
No, you go in here so you can get food and healables.
That's true. That's really neat. I just like that they're like, all right, well, the mall's got to have a food court. Where is this?
Malls are all dead now. I miss malls as like a thing that you used to be able to go to.
God, yeah.
You know, the first sign that your mall's dying is the moment they get rid of the movie theater.
Yeah.
Everything falls after that.
Yeah. I went to one of my smaller, we have these things called Westfield, they're mall chains. I went to one of the smaller Westfields after COVID, and it was gone.
Is it like a open field mall?
No. It's like a just regular, normal-ass shopping mall. I don't know where the fuck this place is. This is some of the crappiest level design I've seen. It's so straightforward in the original.
Yeah, I don't know. This is stupid. I think in Postal 2 there's an Easter egg where you can travel forward in time by Postal 4.
It's pretty funny.
Coming through.
This is like they had a really simple ball layout. They made it like really complicated.
Retarded.
Where is this? Do I have to go in the other end?
Yeah, you do. This is dumb. Yeah, no, you have to
leave the mall and go around and go in the other end. Oh my god. Oh my god.
This is retarded, dude. I don't know what were they thinking. What were they thinking?
Are you fucking serious? Jesus Christ. Yay.
Oh, here we go. All right,
let's see what we got. All right.
Oh, those are Sterns.
Shut the fuck up.
No, I'm glad you taught me about the difference between pinball machines.
I actually taught you which pinball machines were good and which weren't.
Oh, can you actually play that?
Probably. Yep. I taught you what a good pinball machine was. I think it was when we were in Atlantic City and I found out they had a Cactus Canyon machine and I was just delighted for hours.
They have a really good pinball hall there.
They have a really great one.
I remember you were telling me when you went with Hessa to go to a pinball hall and all of it was Stern.
It was, I think we paid $40 to go down there and it was all Stern. It was all just like crap.
Yeah, no, here you go to like this fucking casino and it just has like an actual arcade pinball hall.
It's got the good shit.
Hey. Hi there. I'm here to deliver this season's hot new game sensation courtesy of Papa Desi.
I'm sorry, but I cannot accept a video game that espouses such vile and immoral things. I must reject your violent game on my moral grounds.
You better accept this game unless you want to see your insides strewn across those moral grounds.
You got spunk. He's getting based in schizo.
Oh no.
Tell you what, meet me in the back room and maybe we can work out a deal.
Very well.
All right, here we go. Employees only.
Oh no. Balls.
I think that's an actual game.
You see?
Not that, but I remember there was like a.
You might say I'm the kingpin of a massive gun trafficking operation. But you didn't hear that from me.
Wow.
Right now, I only need he's
going on his monologue and the postal dude's just like, I don't feel so good. My stomach hurts.
And I'll be happy to take that game off your hands.
Why don't I have these guns? Why don't I just kill this guy? Oh, because I can't. Oh, never mind, I can.
This is bad for me. How am I going to deliver these motherboards now?
Well...
Why not just install the motherboards into the arcade cabinets yourself?
Good thinking, Brain.
Good thinking. Alright, you gotta go to the four rent ones.
Yeah.
Feels so good.
Balls. We wanna play the balls machine.
Yeah, that'd be a great pinball game.
This isn't quite as it's not as insane as Eternal Damnation. Cause that is a completely serious game. That's the weirdest thing about it.
I like the crap polo. I always love the ways that they, just going low in health, dude.
Oh, I know. Yeah, I'll just shoot this guy.
How am I gonna deliver these motherboards now?
Why did I give away my guns?
Why not just install the motherboards?
Eternal Damnation, yeah, it's great. Our stream is up on YouTube of Eternal Damnation if you guys haven't watched it.
You gotta
go watch that shit. It's good.
We've been getting a lot of the VODs up on YouTube.
Yeah.
A lot. Way more than, I would say that we've definitely made up for previous months where we had been doing a little bit of droughts.
Yeah.
But, it's all there. It's all there this time.
It's all there.
You won't be disappointed.
You won't. That's something for everybody.
Yeah, I think we've done We've done like three streams of Eternal Damnation, and the one with Hess is the best. That's the definitive version.
That's the one that's preserved.
Yeah, that's the one we preserved. Because it's great.
It's good to be selective about that.
Yeah. I feel like shit. It is good to be like, okay, yep, this is the definitive one.
There's nothing wrong with returning back to the scene of a crime, you know?
Nope.
Doing another game again, but this time with more feeling.
Looks like I agree.
Time to return to the church.
Alright, so we're not going to be able to do the entire game.
No.
What would you think is a good place to stop?
We'll do Wednesday. And then we'll stop.
That's a good one.
I wouldn't mind doing the base game with you, because that's the one I actually like.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind
but
it either.
But here's the thing.
I've thought to myself, like, why haven't we?
Yeah. Well, we got to do Wednesday.
Because it's too easy of an answer. It's too easy.
We got to do Wednesday, because Milo is on Wednesday.
I think... No, Milo's on...
Great job, dude. The church
Thursday.
Really appreciates the
work
you put in.
I think he's in the club on Wednesday.
Yeah, you want to find
and yeah, the Yik patch is coming soon.
For I have the knowledge you need to know.
Milo Postal.
Yes,
no, Milo Postal.
Milo's on Thursday, damn.
And all I need yeah, I knew it. I knew it.
To find and cure champ,
Wednesday,
that one
Thursday,
single
Friday.
Secret you need to know is... What the...
Oh yeah, the zombies in this have mad cow disease. In case you remember 2003.
Yeah.
Remember to take these guys out. You gotta go for the head.
Mad cow zombies.
How's it going?
This microphone's clipping.
Vince? Oh, great. Now my day is complete.
Nothing personal, man, but you're fired from life.
Damn, this whole place is being overrun.
Oh, God, seriously?
Yeah, you forgot. That's
Damn,
what's so annoying about the health
overrun.
Fight.
I better find a way out of here.
I'm eating dog food because it's the only food I got.
It looks like the day is done. Time to return to the church. I gotta find more of that good stuff.
Oh, you guys see Smiling Friends got a confirm on season 2? Yes, I saw.
Yeah, that's this weekend.
This weekend, damn. Are you excited for Yik?
Yeah. I mean, is it gonna be just a good game? Now,
what if it's a masterpiece, sir? What if we play the game and it's an absolute masterpiece? We were wrong, they were right. They put us in the game and we're burning on crosses.
That's what the Bored Ape. Remember the Bored Ape family?
Oh, of course.
That's what they did for all the people that
that doubted the apes.
Yeah, no, they actually drew them in the show, looking like fucking all fat, stupid.
Oh, of course.
I remember when I looked on OpenSea how much the Bored Ape cartoon was to own the minted version of it.
Mm-hmm.
As an NFT, and it costs about $300.
Oh, let's get it.
That was my first thought.
Damn, $300 for a beautiful ape?
No, the whole cartoon. You'll be the owner.
We could own a cartoon.
They made on Fox an NFT cartoon. Dan Harmon produced NFT cartoon called Crapopolis, and it came out like a year after NFTs like were out.
Oh man!
So they were just stuck with this thing that has like that was like this cartoon on Fox, this Fox cartoon that was mintable.
Oh.
No one wanted it anymore.
Oh no.
I kind of miss when Bored Apes were like a thing.
Did you know Kevin Smith made a movie that was made only on NFT?
No.
Well, there you go. It's very funny to think about Kevin Smith and how he was like talked up to be Gen X's Woody Allen.
Yeah, at least he didn't do the Woody Allen
stuff. Yeah, at least he wasn't like Woody Allen.
At least his only crime is just being kind of an annoying epic fat guy.
He's like being a guy who gets really into weed at 36.
Here we are. We're here.
Oh shit,
okay.
We are here. Yes.
Okay. All right. Kill all the zombies here, and I want you to go to the read the tombstones, and I'll tell you which one.
Splatter Pope and Postal Girl. Peen Boy.
Peen Boy.
And there's a flower there.
Flowers for Peen Boy.
Handcuffs, kinky.
There's a specific... Oh, shit. Still alive.
Animal fucking clones.
What's this one?
Rape Clowns 2.
Okay.
My nads.
I do love a good
sign gag. Good Samaritan training course.
What's that one?
The pigeon mission, again.
Alright, you didn't read all of them in the other one.
What other one?
There was the other graveyard.
Did I go through it?
Yeah.
Oh no.
Alright, what's that one?
Remote control cats.
Okay, keep going. It's not. Oh yeah, there's another one over here.
That beloved bookcase.
Yep,
oh.
P.
This one?
Yeah. Does it do it?
What, the bookcase?
What fucking?
It shows like a crazy weird NPC.
Huh.
Aw, man.
You got lied to.
No, it was on the wiki.
The beloved bookcase is the bookcase in the bank, which opens up a secret entrance. And I think the game's journalism one is in the base game, weirdly enough. At least I think it is. Sombrero Lincoln.
If Postal Dude pisses on the tombstone, the beloved bookcase will appear carrying knuckle dusters. Aw, man.
What? Is that true? Is that on the wiki?
Yeah.
If you piss, alright, maybe I'm not pissing in the right direction.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe it's on certain days? I don't know. You were peeing blood earlier.
Well, maybe it was taken too...
I don't know. Maybe they patch it out or something? I don't know.
Maybe it broke the game.
Yeah,
no, it's in here. You have to do it pixel perfect. Is that true? Maybe. Maybe I just gotta piss more. It happens
on
the original... Oh.
No, but on the wiki it doesn't say that, though.
Oh, so it's not... Okay. Really? I didn't know that.
Unique NPC that can be summoned in Paradise Lost.
Oh, really? Okay. Wait a minute. Maybe I just gotta pee a lot on it.
Yeah, keep peeing.
What's the secret? Just keep pissing.
What's the chat saying?
What's the chat saying? What's the money? What's the money saying?
What fucking moron designed this?
99% of pissers give up before they hit the perfect stream.
Fuck you.
Where's the Satoru Iwata gravestone?
Yeah.
What fucking moron designed this?
There's a couple of like different people that if you desecrate their memory that people will fucking kill you.
One of them is
Iwata and the other one is Etika.
Yeah, everyone loves Etika. I think that's like the Zoomers' first instance of oh whoops we killed someone through the computer.
Yep. I like that. It's funny that Keepstar basically told him to just jump.
Yeah. Oh man.
I'm glad that people don't let him let it go.
Some people are just not capable of feeling shame.
That's why people like that don't get run off the internet.
Well, of course.
If you don't have a reputation to ruin.
We are triumphant over the zombie oppressor Vince and his clan. And who do we have here?
Don't mind me. I'm just passing through.
Holy me! It's the dude! Vince's second in command.
This is really weird.
The tyrant who exterminated so many of our kind and whipped my ass 11 years ago. Quick, my minions, take him prisoner.
Oops.
We have some unfinished business to take care of. You're gonna be spending the night in the junkyard.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Hell, what a day that was. I saw my former employer become one of the undead, got captured by a horde of mad cow Tourette's zombies, and finally ended
Tourette's
up in prison.
Tourette's was really, really funny back in the day.
Tourette's was a, yes.
Despite all that, I'm still no
very go-to joke.
Champ. Yep, looks like it's another fine mess you've gotten yourself into. How do you plan to get out of this one, Skippy? Say, I've been meaning to ask, is there someone else hanging around inside my mind?
Oh, pay no attention to me. I'm just that little voice in the back of your head.
Ooh.
But don't you worry. I'll be out of your hair soon enough. Don't look now, but your friend Beelzebessie's headed this way.
It is my lady, oh! It is my love! Soon we'll be together in loving matrimony! But first, I need to take care of that cash flow problem. You there! The dreaded undead oppressor! I need your help! I have just met the true love of my life! And we are set to be wed today! Our marriage will be beautiful, but there are still errands to be completed before the ceremony! My zombie minions are too brain dead to be of any use, so you will perform these tasks for us!
And what's in it for me?
Help us, and we won't feast upon your flesh and wear your shredded entrails as neckties!
Fair enough. What do I have to do?
I require money in order to satisfy my soon-to-be-wed wife's insatiable chocolate habit. It would be immoral to take your cash, so we'll earn the funds the good old-fashioned way, through a scam charity. Just ask any yokel you can find in town for donations. Charity money will only get us so far. Bring me a breast pump so that I may make a fortune selling my kosher daddy's milk to the public. There should be one at the local.
This certainly is a video game.
Yeah, I don't know. Did you hear about that fucking the Mandela catalog guy? The guy that made some analog horror thing, and it turned out his entire popular series turned out to just be fetish. His thinly veiled fetish.
Yeah, people get mad at that, but that's literally every piece of art. It's like, oh, well, the whole thing was a vehicle for your fetish? Yeah, so was everything.
So was Alien.
Yeah, exactly. You think Giger didn't think the alien was sexy? Oh, duh.
Say, it looks like former child star
someone's,
Zach Ward is
saw someone say,
to
feel with no girlfriend was it awesome, but it had potential. I don't know what that's referring to, but I'm just imagining like a video game called that, and I'm just imagining people be like
oh
disappointed
my God.
About it.
That's referring to the documentary series, the documentary That Feel When No Girlfriend, which the director of that had sex with all of those dudes involved, and like I think like some weird shit happened, and basically I don't know if you remember Cantbot, but he like doxed
Cantbot has a baby,
he doxed all of them or something. I haven't talked to him in years. He like blocked me because I said Logo Daedalus looks like Milhouse.
Both of those guys actually won. Both of those guys managed to actually get out of that circle at like...
No, he didn't get out. He just spends all day posting about how much he hates the Red Scare girls now.
Well, he has a baby.
That's weirder. That's the weirdest thing, is that he has a living child.
Would it be better if he didn't have a living child?
I don't know. Depends. That's one of those... Yeah, I mean, Campbot is...
His baby was a Hitler. Or a Stalin, yeah.
Oh yeah. I forgot the Red Scare girl has a child. A baby that's just being neglected.
That is the world's most neglected baby.
Oh man, being how old are they? Like 38 and like having your online racist phase, like your online reactionary phase when you're 38. I don't understand it.
People had a lot of reverence for them. And that just went away.
It was a very dumb time to be on the computer. I think that's what we're learning. I think that's what we're learning.
You got an eBay guy right now.
Do you mind if, as we wind down, that I show you the weird mods for this game?
Sure.
Sure, you don't mind?
Yeah, Wednesday's a good place to stop.
Wednesday, well, I want to show you something. I'd like to show you something in the, but it's in the base game.
Go for it.
So, I installed the weird Russian DLC that is only available in Russia, and it has actors phonetically dubbing it in English. People who are Russian and they're trying to speak English. Okay, wait, hang on. I have to do something very special to get this to launch. One second.
Kevin Hart made an NFT animated series.
Oh my god. Do you remember when Snoop Dogg and Eminem had their had a music video and it was their NFTs?
Do you remember Seth Green's NFT show and his ape got kidnapped?
I don't remember any of these. Are these real?
I'll put up the Seth Green one.
The Seth Green ape?
Yeah, this one I think is the more interesting one.
Oh boy, are you guys ready? This is a video game. Oh god, what was that? Alright, you ready?
Yeah.
Real?
Yes, oh. That's real, dude.
How did people pay money for this?
Hey, welcome, friend. What's your name?
Wow, boy. You know, this is not going the way that I planned.
Is this a TV
hey,
show?
Hey, Gary.
How are you? It was going to, maybe? They really overpraised how much this was going to stay, power this was going to have.
Remember NFT?
I'm just saying, that's who they part, maybe tonight.
I kind of want that rose.
Don't take the rose,
please. Dating an NFT. this is, I like how this is basically, what is it? This is, who framed Roger Rabbit, of NFTs? And it's awesome.
That's an ambitious thing to do.
You're about one G&T away from a screaming match. Now those two are doomed.
Oh my god. This is a show that had three seasons and no one watched it.
I know. Want me to rough him up? I am the only gay guy in my ballet class who can make a fist.
What?
What?
We need a festival. A festival for people who do not depend on anyone.
You're never in a relationship.
Just cheers for NFTs.
If I don't come in Monday, pick me up at the ICU.
They should bring it back. Bring back NFTs. Yeah. Bring it back. I want it back.
Can you imagine if you were like a working actor and you just wanted to have like residuals for this? Alright, are you ready, sir?
Yeah.
Wait, I hardly have to show it to you, don't I?
Yeah.
Oh god, hang on. Can you see it? Nope, never mind. Yeah.
Alright, I should be in now.
Oh, God.
So this is the Russia-only DLC.
This is the Russian DLC. Oh, God. Whoa, hang on. Oh, no, it screwed up. One sec. Yeah. Uno momento. The guy that made this died in Ukraine? Oh no.
Really?
Probably. Oh man, this is a level of humor I don't quite get. Oh man.
The Russian shitpost mod industry is insane.
I don't understand this at all. This is just inscrutable.
No, yeah, no. Russian shitposts are all just completely inscrutable. There's one for GTA.
Oh, I bet.
I was thinking of playing. Oh, remember Titan Thrice?
Yes.
They made a San Andreas. Amnesia. He doesn't know how to
open a zipper. Well, that's good. Quite neat and roundish. Shouldn't we put more silicone, though? We're short on silicone, actually, but he's okay already. He doesn't speak, but he walks and even dances, now that there's nothing between his legs. Well, I think we can release him then. As you say, Professor.
We misspelled Professor.
Professor with two F's.
And one S.
What the fuck happened to me? Where am I? Who am I?
awful subtitles.
Oh my god.
That dog doesn't know shit. I can speak very well. Let's try it.
Yeah, right. I can talk. Fuck. What's wrong with my voice? Maybe my balls are asleep or something.
How are you, my babies?
What on earth?
You can go, patient.
What's the holy fuck? Strings? Where's my dick?
Venus. Remember Sperto?
Remember Venus? So, this English dub is only available in the Japanese version. Originally, this was in Russian. Oh my god.
This should be its own stream. I'm gonna say this now.
We might have to come back to this. It is so inscrutable.
I think we shouldn't go too far into this.
Oh,
I
no,
think.
We're just gonna look at this.
Just let's see some textures.
Nobody's watering these flowers except me.
Yeah, you also can't pee because your dick got cut off. So you just do that. You this. What does this mean? I'm sure this is really funny.
I like how this completely throws away the ambiance.
Oh yeah, no.
Change for playing ska.
Yes, there is a ska soundtrack.
Russian gamers are very fascinating to me because they all just make stuff like this.
I'm sure this is really funny. If I could...
Like, you get the feeling that it is. Like, sometimes you'll see something and it's like, like in a different language, like, it's probably not that funny. But whenever you see Russian shit posts like this, like, you get this feeling that it's funny.
Like, I'm sure this is, I don't know what this is. I'm sure this is hilarious.
Go on udaf.com.
I'm fucking cured.
I'm fucking cured.
Oh, man. I'm sure this is hilarious.
Gopniks are probably the funniest people on the planet.
I don't understand.
But why are they funny? What? Ah, oh, man.
I think there's something about Russian games where they barely work and that's kind of the joke. Like, Postal 3 is Russian. It is a Russian game. And it is barely functioning. To the point where the loading screen tips are even like, yeah, good luck.
You know the stalker mod where the screws you throw are replaced by dogs, and someone says the hard R, but it's misspelled.
Oh no, really?
That is a wild thing to be able to... That's a wild thing to, like, misspell.
I can understand why there's a Russian DLC for this game, because Postal 2 is the closest, like, devs have, like, gotten to making Slavjank. It is Slavjank.
So this is official.
This is an officially licensed Postal 2 DLC that was only released in Russia.
But why didn't we get it?
Because it is the very Russian, and it has, I don't know. It was intended solely for the Russian market.
It's that profitable and lucrative?
I guess. I think Russian developers were just like, hey, we want to make this thing. Is that cool? And they were like, yeah, sure.
I would assume that the franchise was like a bit, you know.
The
point where it's dead. So, like, they were like, oh, hell yeah, go ahead.
No, I think Akella might have worked on Apocalypse Weekend a bit. And they were just like, oh, yeah, no, go ahead. You can make this. And then they just went and they made it. And it's kind of notoriously bad.
That was good.
It's the thing that always strikes me, like, even when I download, like, Russian Doom mods, is just, they're just inscrutable.
You know what I feel like we unfortunately, like, got into the Twitch game a bit too late, too.
What?
His band. Grezzo 2.
Oh, that. Yeah, Jesus. See,
we can't stream that.
We're not allowed to stream that.
Done by now.
I would have done it.
Were.
But, like, that's an Italian Doom 2 mod, but even I don't understand why it's... I don't understand any of the jokes. Half the humor is just blasphemy. Like... there's references to like the Italian version of PewDiePie and you can kill him.
I didn't know that.
It's Ridge Racer! Ridge Racer!
Speaking of where Russian dames thought fair like a Vopnik ship posts when are you going to?
That would be worth
Stop
playing.
Fallout and Stalker crossover Fallout Billy Mod.
If you play as a girl, you instantly die. That'd be cool. I wouldn't mind.
Instantly die.
I'm noticing now the ROM hack community has been making such insane like leaps and bounds like developments like the Mario with a shotgun mod that's like really competently made that I streamed.
Yeah,
like people are starting to even start to bring that into like the GameCube and PS2 era.
Yeah,
so like we're starting to see some insane like ROM hacks for games that are like console games from post 2000 now.
Yeah,
so we're gonna be starting to see a lot of new crazy things be made, and I'm really excited about it. I love the ska, it's so inspiring.
Hey, just having a ska soundtrack.
So what makes this game particularly bad?
Well, it's just a shit post, basically. And these guys made Postal 3.
Oh, really?
Yes, this is the team that would later go on to make Postal 3, the Russians.
Oh. Them and, like, the Postal team had a falling out for that game.
Well, basically, yeah. Oh, I'm sure this is very funny.
So are you supposed to be the postal dude here?
No, you're the postal dude, but your dick got cut off or something.
But now you're in Russia.
Yes. What's happening? What?
I love the dub acting.
The dub acting is the best part of this, and I need to turn it up a bit.
It's so delightfully ESL.
It's so great.
They all talk like excuse.
Yeah, excuse.
Chot, chot, chot. Chot, chot.
Chot. I don't know, I think Russian games are just... they're just like this.
I can't get into the mindset of someone that watches fucking Pokemon
Okay, I... Oh, the version of crack in this game is vodka. See, I'm sure this is hilarious. I'm sure this is the funniest thing in the world. Like, they just have memes in their game. Like, this is a licensed game, and it's just got whatever the fuck...
Pillsbury Doughboy...
It's just got... They don't care about copyright.
Yonkis.com. I love going on Yonkis.com.
They just have shit like this. They just don't care.
This is... Like, I love the ska. It feels like I'm playing Tony Hawk.
It does feel like Tony Hawk, doesn't it? Yes.
It's so stupid. What a stupid fucking design choice. I love it.
It's just baffling. Everything about it is baffling.
We gotta revisit this later.
I think we do, yeah. I can't even...
You can't stray too far.
No. Okay, there's just a picture of a girl here.
What?
There's babies on the wall. Yeah, what?
I was
yeah,
gonna say.
There's so... What is this? This is so weird. Is this just a house? What is... Why is this a level? Is this a... What?
Why did you have to do a loading zone?
Yeah, what the fuck? Home sweet home... Okay. Why is there...
That was good.
Oh my god. Yes.
Did you ever get your dick back?
Well, that's the kind of, that's the central motivation of this game. This is just what Russia is like, from what I understand.
I would love to one day go. I thought this was the stupid fucking baby wallpaper again.
Wait, what?
I don't know what that weapon
was. That was a sock? A sock? No, I like this just because it's baffling. It's, you don't know what's happening. You're not sure why it, what
the fuck is that?
I think that's the poster for The Descent. I don't know. Like, I'm sure this is very funny.
I had no idea that this existed.
You didn't? Oh, now you do. No. Now you do.
If they knew this existed, I would have recommended you stream this before. This is insane.
This is the most baffling thing I think I've ever seen, like, on the stream. In that, like, there's no... The thing with, like, Russian movies is that there's no end point. There's no point where, like... Unless you are from Russia and you were born at a certain time, you will not be able to understand most Soviet films. Or, like, most late 80s Russian films, or just anything. It's so alien.
Worker in Parasite is pretty straightforward, though. I don't know. That's just me. What's this? Very funny. And we're not making... And we're not, like... dogging on it.
We're not dogging on it.
I'm jealous because they at least have some knowledge. Oh, I love those kind of movies.
Oh goodness.
Damn, there is no grenade jumping.
Please blame a grenade for my death.
That's so good.
Delightfully ESL.
That was probably really funny in the other original language. This reminds me of the Nameless mod. Yes, it reminds me of that. The Nameless mod is a Deus Ex mod that takes place entirely on the Deus Ex Planet forums. It is a game about being on a forum.
Why haven't you played that?
Well... it might even be too alien. Like, I'm sure this is probably what... Oh, that's Excel.
People love, like, internet splunking like that.
They do. Like, even yeah. I would... Even I don't understand half that crap.
Yeah. We all come together. We try to work backwards.
We try and figure it out.
We can't even figure out why there's so much ska music in this.
Why is there ska music? We don't know.
There is no grenade.
All right, that'll do. I think we've seen enough. Oh,
we'll,
God.
We'll be back to this someday.
We will return, but for now, do we have any more videos that we sent in?
Let's see if we have any redemptions.
We do not.
Oh, we do not.
Do you have anything you'd like to send in? Now's your chance. What are you doing tomorrow, sir?
I'm probably playing Needy Streamer Overdose.
Oh, that's a fun one. You're going to have fun with that.
I am. I saw that today that there is... Oh, my God. there's a lot of stuff on sale on Steam after last sale. So I picked up a couple things. Probably not going to, like, immediately stream all of them at once. But there's... I have a lot of simulator games I bought.
Hell yeah. And I'll be back next Saturday for more Alpha Protocol. If you liked that, we're gonna finish that up. We're gonna bust the conspiracy and continue role playing as a weird psycho. Thanks, guys. I hope you liked that stream. That was fun.
Do we raid Chapo?
Let's do it.
It's been a while.
Take care, guys. Enjoy. Stay safe.
keep our name in their minds.
That's how we do it.